So this is the first of two webinars we'll be broadcasting to prepare you for your upcoming editing journey with us, or continuing with us, which is undeniably one of the most important components of your book's preparation for your soon-to-be readers. So let's dive right in with an explanation of the often misunderstood world of editing. I'll be discussing the definition of editing in general, our approach to it here at Tellwell, and how you will go about navigating your process with us. We'll be getting into a brief description of the editor's job, what it is and what it is not, who the editors on our team are, our menu of services, and what you will need to begin your process, as well as what to expect back from your editor after your editing has started. We will make sure to follow this one up with our next editing webinar, part two, which will be about working with your edits through the revision process. We'll be getting specific about the software interface that you'll be working with, Microsoft Word track changes and such. Now, there's a common phrase we often find repeated in how-to books and classes on the craft of writing that claims writing is rewriting. Now, this is considered to be an undisputed pearl of wisdom amongst professional writers, but what does that actually mean? Essentially, it's simple logic that says the more you hone your writing, your words, your sentences, chapters, your ideas, the clearer and cleaner your story will be to your reader. This will make them more likely to recommend your book to others, of course, through word of mouth, or across the interwebs on its various platforms. And this is widely considered to be the surest road to literary success. The problem is it's very hard to have a clear perspective on what needs to change in our own work from draft to draft. And this is because our words end up deeply entrenched in our minds and our hearts by the time we get to the editing stage. So rewriting our books into that final draft can take an agonizingly long time. This is why every author you've ever loved has worked in concert for a long time with a skilled editor, because it's the most efficient way to break through our biases and our blocks to enable us to craft the best work we're capable of. Now, the number one fear of new writers when it comes to working with an editor we find is that this person will make sweeping changes to our work, causing it to lose the very essence of what makes it uniquely ours. Trust me, this could not be further from the truth, okay? The hallmark of a skilled editor is to be able to get in sync with our unique voice on the page and support it through the editing process. They should be our greatest champion, basically encouraging our personal style, pointing out areas where our stories can be strengthened and clarified. Essentially, our editor greases the wheels of the rewriting process, which propels us to the publication stage, confident and excited about our work. They're our new teammate, somewhat of a coach, if you will. Tellwell, your editor will make no permanent changes to your manuscript. This is important to note. Every note or change that you'll find from your editor is merely a suggestion based on many years of expertise in storytelling. And these suggestions can be kept, altered, dismissed altogether as you see fit. Your editing process should be a conversation with a friend who has your book's best interest at heart. It's not a class to pass or fail. Every final decision on your book's composition lies with you and you alone. Your editor becomes a trusted partner, someone on your team looking out for you and your readers. Okay, so who are these editor types we employ here at Tellwell? We have a deep roster of wonderful publishing professionals that we're very proud of, who have proven themselves to be not only outstanding at the craft of editing, but they're people who love supporting our authors and working with them in positive, intuitive ways to make their stories strong and powerful, to make them sing in your unique voice, as it were. We recruit editors with long careers in publishing who have attained accreditation from various schools and editing organizations in Canada and the US. All our editors are above all else genre generalists. They're strong in all book styles, but each of them brings to the team various specializations and strengths, from fiction or kids' books to academic, nonfiction works, everything in between. So we have great fits for all our books on our editing roster. We're very proud of our editors and their approach to their author's work, and we're always very excited to introduce you to your new partner in the writing process. So let's talk a bit about our menu of services here at Tellwell. We offer several options for working with an editor to meet your book-specific needs. And let's start with the editorial evaluation. In the evaluation, the eval, as we call it around the office, your editor will read your manuscript and then compose a report outlining its current strengths and weaknesses. They will offer recommendations for broad ways that it can be improved before you submit it for a more rigorous editing service. No actual edits are made to the manuscript itself in an eval. Next up is the copy edit. Now, this represents the most basic level of editing. It's a mechanical edit to address issues of English usage, grammar, punctuation, to ensure a professionally presented manuscript that's clear and consistent in style. It'll make sure there's no embarrassing typos or objective errors in language usage. There are no specific edits to address the more artistic subjective elements of your composition. And then the big one, the substantive edit. This is our most popular editing service. The substantive comprises two unique rounds of editing. The first is what we call a content edit, which will examine the foundation of the story's narrative to make sure it's both clear and logical to the reader. It'll have a look at the structure and clarity of the sentences themselves. You'll be offered notes on pacing, structure, logical consistency, the force of your language, how well your themes are representing themselves is a big one. Then that's returned to you for your consideration and your revisions, after which you send the new draft back to your editor, who performs a copy edit, as we discussed earlier. That's the second part of the substantive, to catch any errors in grammar, usage, punctuation, to tidy things up and make it sleek and professional. The substantive edit is considered within the broader publishing industry to be the base standard for the editing process. It's our highest selling service, and it represents the best value financially. Multiple rounds of editing certainly offer your book its best chance of market success. And if you and your editor or your project manager feel it's necessary, you always have the option of purchasing a third round of editing in a substantive as well, if together you feel the book needs just a bit more polishing. Finally, we have the proofread. Now, this is a final detail-oriented pass of the manuscript to make sure it's ready for the marketplace. It takes place after the book has gone through the design process, after editing and design, and approved by you, and just before it goes to print. So the proofread checks for any sneaky errors that may have made it through all the editing. You have to remember that in traditional publishing, books are edited many, many times. This is a luxury that is, of course, cost prohibitive in self-publishing. So sometimes little errors can slither their way through the proof to the proofread stage. It also checks for any accidental formatting errors that may have been introduced during the design phase, through any potential software translation errors, that kind of thing. Proofreads are a unique form of edit, and they're only available to add to your package if you already purchased one of the earlier editing services. So what will you need to get started? You will need access to a good working computer with an up-to-date version of Microsoft Word. Word remains the industry standard for this kind of thing due to the robustness of its editing functionality. We get into the nuts and bolts of this in the second editing webinar, the companion to this one. And you will need your complete manuscript saved in one single Microsoft Word document to send to us through Octavo. And once you've done that, once you've submitted your manuscript through Octavo, that online project management system that we use, you will complete an editorial questionnaire, your EQ as we call it, which will offer your editor heaps of insight into your hopes and dreams for your book, and your goals for the editing process. This is the beginning of your conversation with your editor, a conversation which continues within the manuscript itself. It's important to remember that the more prepared and polished your manuscript is before it's submitted for editing, the deeper the value of your editing service, the most bang for your buck. This means if you have anyone in your family or your circle of friends who have any facility with the language and you trust them, it's not a bad idea to have them give it a read, to offer some notes, to tighten things up before it gets to the professional editor you're paying your hard-earned money for. This will let them dig deeper into the edit, and you know, the better your final book will be for it. Don't rush your EQ. The more detail you can provide, the easier it will be for your editor to get on the same page with you, so to speak, and provide you with a richer editing experience. When you take the time to provide detailed and specific responses in your EQ, you're setting yourself and your editor up for success. Now, what should you expect back from your editor? Following your first round of editing, the content edit, you'll be sent back an email with links to download three files. The project deliverable file contains what we call your marked up copy of the manuscript. This is the one with all the edits on it, both within the text itself and in queries to you and notes in the sidebar of the pages. Remember that none of the suggested changes you'll find in the lines of text are permanent. They can be accepted, changed, or rejected as you see fit. This one is the file you will do your next work on, your next round of work on for your revisions. You need to go through and accept or reject each edit suggestion and then work and do all your revisions on that copy. You'll also receive a clean copy as a reference copy. This is just to show you how the adjusted manuscript would read if you accepted each of your editor's suggestions. Sometimes it's easier to read the clean copy when you're deciding on a change rather than the marked up version. It's just there for your convenience if you need it. And you'll get a third file containing your editor's style sheet with a little letter to you about the work, outlining some of the reasoning and rules your editors use to make suggestions for your book. Your editor will always use your personal style as your, as their main guide. That's them getting on the same wave with you. But they have, of course, a wealth of established publishing conventions to fall back on to make sure everything is consistent. And this style guide will explain all of that to you. It also serves as a valuable tool for you just to keep handy during revisions and any further writing you may wish to add as you go through the book again. There are, of course, many ways language can be assembled, and a big part of your editor's job is to make sure that everything within the manuscript is consistent. This, more than anything, makes your book look professional and well-polished. The quest for consistency is the editor's prime directive. So, to give a quick recap of some of the key takeaways from this chat, your editor's primary goal is to strengthen your voice, not change it to sound like theirs. You have several styles of edit to consider, the two-round substantive edit being the best value and the most thorough we can be. Remember to make sure your Microsoft Word program is updated to the most recent version. That's very important. And your editor's job, above all, is to provide consistency and a professional shine to your book. And that's it for the first of your two introduction videos to the editing process here at Tellwell. In the next one, we'll get specific about how you're going to be interacting with your edit and your editing tools in Microsoft Word. And you can check out the slides for this webinar at the link below anytime you like. If you have any questions or comments, as always, feel free to email us at support@tellwell.ca. And of course, stick around for the Q&A session if you like. Drop any questions you might have at this point in the questions tab, and we'll do our best to get to all of them. Thank you so much for your time and your interest, and we'll see you in the editing webinar part 2.